Good day, Grade 12s. Welcome to this first lesson in week one of your Grade 12 year. In this lesson, we're going to be looking at skills for practical investigation. We are going to be looking specifically at the scientific method, which is very important because not only are you going to have to do practicals this year for your CAS, in other words, your continuous assessment, but you will in the final exams, either in your physics or chemistry or maybe even both, be asked about the scientific method. So you need to know this very well. Let us talk about the hypothesis and aim of an experiment. An hypothesis is a best guess. This basically is saying that we are trying to decide what we think is going to happen as an outcome of an experiment, and it must relate to two variables. So let's think of an example. What about if we looked at how the amount of sun a plant gets affects its growth rate? Okay, so there what we're doing is we're relating the amount of sun to the growth rate of a plant. Okay, so it must relate to the two variables. And it can be wrong. So a hypothesis might be, if we're relating the two variables of the sun and the plant growth, a hypothesis could be that the amount of sun does not affect the growth rate of the plant, or it could be that the greater the amount of sun, the greater the growth rate of the plant, or it could be that the more sun the plant gets, the less it grows. So do you see, it doesn't matter which way we're relating them, as long as we're relating the two variables, and it doesn't matter if hypothesis is right or wrong. Right, now let's talk about the aim of the experiment. Now, a lot of students confuse hypothesis with aim. So you need to think about this carefully. The aim is what we are going to investigate. So in this case, we are going to investigate how the amount of sun a plant gets affects its growth rate. Okay, do you see the difference? In the hypothesis, we're saying what we think is going to happen. In the aim, we're explaining what we're going to investigate. Now, you get two types of data. You get quantitative data and you get qualitative data. Now, quantitative data, this is something that can be measured. For example, your length, your area, your volume, your time, or your speed. Whereas qualitative data cannot be measured. So you'd be looking at your change in color or your production of smell. So in other words, if you say that there is a production of smell, we could say, okay, well, we could definitely smell a change in smell. It might smell like rotten eggs, but we can't measure that smell. We can't say, oh, this is a level six in the smell of rotten eggness. Okay, so this is qualitative. Do we smell it or do we not? Okay, quantitative is how long something is, how big something is, how fast it is. Okay, you need to know the difference between these two types of data. Now let's talk about variables. In the last slide, we spoke about variables when we spoke about our hypothesis and we said that we needed to relate our variables. Now let's talk about the different type of variables. So as you can see from this graph, we have at least two different types of variables, dependent and independent variables. In fact, there are three types of variables. We've got the dependent variable, the independent variable, and a variable which is called controlled or fixed, but we'll talk about that in a second. So let's talk about the dependent variable. The dependent variable is the variable that we measure. So if we go back to our example of how sun affects the growth rate, we would be measuring the length or the growth rate of the plants. That would be our dependent variable. And the dependent variable is always represented on the y-axis of your graph. Dependent variable is always represented on the y-axis of the graph. The independent variable is the one that we change. So again, if we go back to our example where we're talking about how much sun affects the plant growth, the independent variable would be how much sun the plant is getting. So we could change that from no sun to lots of sun, or from no sun to 2 hours of sun, 4 hours of sun, 6 hours of sun, etc. So the independent variable is the one that we change, and it is always represented on the x-axis, always represented on the x-axis. And obviously from the names, the dependent variable depends on the independent variable. Right, now let's talk about the control or fixed variable. This is the variable that we keep the same. We don't allow it to change. And the reason we do that is that we need to keep this constant in order to achieve what we call a fair test. And what is a fair test? A fair test is one where these other variables, the variables that we need to keep control fixed, don't affect the experiment. So for example, again, if we're talking about how quickly our plants grow with respect to the amount of sun that they get given, one of the variables that we'd have to keep in control would be the amount of water that the plant gets or the temperature of the room, things like that. Okay, so you need to think about what variables you need to keep fixed or controlled that may affect the outcome of the experiment. Now we've spoken about the hypothesis, the aim, and the variables. Now let's talk about the method of our experiment. Now, before we start an experiment, we always have to think about our precautions. In other words, what do we need to be careful of? And one of the things that we can do is to make sure that we're always safe and that we're not going to get hurt. So some things that we can use for this are safety glasses or a fume cupboard. Now, why would we Right, let's talk about results, analysis, conclusions, and recommendations. So what's important about the results? Well, results really are just a list of your data or a way of representing your data. But what you have to be careful of is you need to make sure that you present it in an appropriate manner. So in Matric, we really just use tables or graphs. So what's important about these tables and graphs? So first of all, let's talk about